Dear learners, how are you? I hope all of you are in sound mind with sound health. COVID-19 has detached you from your classroom study for a long time. This detachment is hampering your study severely. So, Sirajganj Online School has arranged online classes for you. I am Abul Kalam Azad, Assistant Professor in English of Belkusi Government College, welcoming you to join the online class. I hope if you join the class attentively, you will be highly benefited. Dear learners, in the previous class, I discussed transformation of sentence from your English second paper. Today, I will discuss change of voice in this chapter. I am sure you are very much well known to this chapter, change of voice, as you have solved the problem in previous classes. Yet, I am to discuss the chapter, change of voice. You know that we can change the voice from active to passive form or passive to active form, and we can change assertive sentence, interrogative sentence, and imperative sentence from active to passive form. At first, I am going to change assertive sentence. Active to passive form. To change the voice from active to passive, you will have to at first to detect what kind of sentence is it. At first, I am discussing assertive sentence, and to change the voice from active to passive, you will have to keep in mind that we will have to keep some rules of changing the voice from one form to another. At first, you will have to keep in mind that the subject will be changed into object, then object will be changed into subject. Subject will be changed into object, that means subject will go to the place of object and object will go to the place of subject. The principal verb will be changed into past participle form. Next, auxiliary verb will be changed according to the tense. Next, preposition by will be set up before the object. The other parts of the sentence will remain unchanged. This is the main rules of changing voice. At first, subject will go at the place of object. That means subject will turn into object. Object will go at the place of subject. That means object will be the subject of the sentence. In active voice, we have various forms of principal verb. But in passive voice, there is only one form, and it is past participle form. The principal verb will be changed into past participle. There is only one form in passive voice, and it is past participle form of principal verb. And we'll have to change auxiliary verb according to the tense. According to the tense, all the auxiliary verb will be changed, and it will be set up before the principal verb. And we'll have to use a preposition by before the object, and the other parts of the sentence will remain unchanged. This is the basic rules of active to passive voice of assertive sentence. Now we can give some, I can give you some example according to these rules. How can we change a sentence from active to passive voice? You must keep in mind that we can change a verb from active to passive when the verb is only transitive verb. We can change a transitive verb from active to passive. If the verb is intransitive, we cannot change it from active to passive, as an intransitive verb has no object. As you get no object after an intransitive verb, so we cannot change it into passive voice. So we can only change a transitive verb from active to passive, as it has an object. Now I am discussing some example according to the rules. How can we change an assertive sentence from active to passive? He killed the bird. To change the sentence from active to passive, at first you will have to detect what kind of sentence is it. As the sentence begins with subject, so we are sure that this very sentence is an assertive sentence. Next question, what kind of tense we find? He killed. As we get no auxiliary verb here, so the sentence, whether the sentence is in present intimate tense or in past intimate tense. He killed. As we get the past form of verb, we are sure that this sentence is in past indefinite tense. He killed the bird. Now, our main work is, we'll have to find out subject, verb and object. Here, the subject is he, verb, finite verb, killed, and object, the bird. He killed the bird. Subject, verb and object. We have found subject, verb and object. Now, according to the rules, we will change the object to subject. We will take the object in the place of subject. We will use the object in the place of subject. The bird. Now, we will have to use auxiliary verb. In past intimate tense, we get no auxiliary verb. In every tense, we find various auxiliary verbs, such as he killed, as there is no auxiliary verb, so this sentence is in past indefinite tense. In past indefinite tense or active voice, we get no auxiliary verb, but when we change it into passive voice, we will have was or were after the subject. As the subject is third person singular number, we will have to use was. The bird was now the past participle form of verb. You must keep in mind that in passive form, the only form of verb is past participle. Kill, killed, killed. Now, subject to object, but we'll use a by before the object. He by him. The bird was killed by him. He killed the bird. We have taken the bird object, the bird, to the in the place of subject, the bird. Then, as the sentence is in past indefinite tense, you will have to use was or were as auxiliary verb. As the bird is third person singular verb, you have to use was. Then the past participle of verb. Then we will change subject to object, and before the object you will have to use usually by. The bird was killed by him. When you will change the voice, you must keep in mind that only you will have to change subject, verb and object. If we find any other part in the sentence, this part will remain unchanged. Such as if we extend the sentence, suddenly he killed the bird. Suddenly he killed the bird. We'll try to find out the subject. Subject he, verb killed, and the object the bird. We'll have to change subject, verb and object. Before subject we find an adverb suddenly, and this adverb will remain unchanged. You need not change the other part of the sentence. So suddenly will remain unchanged. Now the same rule, the bird was killed by him. From this sentence we find that if we get any word or phrase before the subject, it will remain unchanged. Now if we get any word or phrase after the subject, what can we do? He killed the bird without any reason. He killed the bird without any reason. Here subject is he, principal verb killed, the object the bird. The other part of the sentence will remain unchanged. We did not change this part of sentence. Now we can change the voice. The bird auxiliary verb was or were, the past participle form of verb, killed by him. He killed the bird. The bird was killed by him without any reason. Without any reason. The bird was killed by him without any reason. There is no sense of this part. But we usually use by plus we object after the sentence, at the end of the sentence. So we can use by plus object at the end of the sentence. By him. The bird was killed without any reason by him. From these two sentences, we find that if we find something before the subject, it will remain unchanged. If we find something after the object, it will remain unchanged. We'll only change subject, verb and object. Now if we find something within subject, verb and object, such as if we write down the sentence again, suddenly he killed the bird without any reason. Suddenly he killed the bird without any reason. We'll have to change only this part of sentence, subject, verb and object, and other parts of the sentence will remain unchanged. Suddenly, now object will go to the place of subject. The bird was killed without any reason. By him. Suddenly the bird was killed without any reason by him. Another sentence. He did for me many unnecessary things. He did for me many unnecessary things. We can change the voice from active to passive in the same way. At first, you will have to detect subject, finite verb, and object, many unnecessary things. Subject, verb, and object for me will remain unchanged. Now, according to the rules of voice, we have to change the object into subject, many things. As the verb is past infinite tense, auxiliary verb was or were, the past participle form of verb do, did, done for me will remain unchanged by he, object, him. Many unnecessary things were done for me by him. Many unnecessary things were done for me by him. Here, for me will remain unchanged. This is how we can change any assertive sentence from active to passive form. Now we can change an interrogative sentence. Have you taken medicine? It's an interrogative sentence. The sentence which asks any question is an interrogative sentence. Have you taken medicine? From the sign of interrogation, we are sure this very sentence is an interrogative sentence. We can change an active to passive. We can change an interrogative sentence from active to passive voice. Have you taken medicine? It's an interrogative sentence. Nothing to be afraid. At first, you will have to change the sentence into assertive sentence. If we set up auxiliary verb after the subject, then it will be an assertive sentence. You have taken medicine. We'll have to change the sentence assertive sentence. We'll set up auxiliary verb after the subject to change the sentence into an assertive sentence. You have taken medicine. Now, according to the rules of an assertive sentence, you will have to change the sentence into passive voice. As we find have or has after the subject, we are sure that this present sentence is in present perfect tense. Now, object to subject, medicine, present perfect tense, the auxiliary verb of passive form, have been or has been. As the medicine is third person single number, you have to use has been. Medicine has been the past participle form of verb taken by you. If the sentence is in assertive form, the voice is medicine has been taken by you, but this sentence is in interrogative form, so we must change the sentence into interrogative. To change the sentence into interrogative, we will have to use auxiliary verb before the subject, but here we find two words in the auxiliary verb, so we can use the first word before the subject. Has medicine been taken by you? Has medicine been taken by you? Another example. Did he draw the picture? From this sign, we are sure it's an interrogative sentence, and we find did before the subject, so it's in past indefinite tense. But at first, we have to change the sentence into assertive. If we can change the sentence into assertive, how can we change the sentence into assertive? He drew the picture. He drew the picture. He drew the picture. Now we can change the voice from active to passive. The picture, as the verb is in past indefinite tense, was drawn by him. Now you will have to change the sentence into interrogative. To make the sentence interrogative, we will have to set up auxiliary verb before the subject. Was the picture drawn by him? You must set up note of interrogation. This is how we can change any interrogative sentence from active to passive. If we have WS before the subject, when have you solved the problem? How have you solved the problem? There is a WS before the interrogative sentence. How can we change the sentence from active to passive? WS will remain unchanged. There will be a change of WS question. Have you solved the problem? If we change the sentence from active to passive, according to the rules of assertive sentence, the answer will be, the problem has been solved by you. If the sentence is in assertive form, the answer is, the problem has been solved by you. But the sentence is in interrogative form, so auxiliary verb will go before the subject. The first part of the auxiliary verb, if we have two or more parts, has the problem been solved by you? Now WS will remain unchanged. How has the problem been solved by you? How has the problem been solved by you? Another question. When did he buy the books? It's also an interrogative sentence. We'll change the sentence into assertive sentence, then we'll change the voice. Did he buy the books? From did, we are sure this present tense is in past limited tense. If we change the sentence into passive form, the answer will be the books were by bought by him. As the sentence is interrogative, so we will set up auxiliary verb before the subject. Were the books bought by him? WS question will remain at the same place. When are the books bought by him? This is how we can solve any problem of interrogative sentence from active to passive. Now, imperative sentence, the sentence which expresses command or order or request or advice, etc. Solve the problem. Carefully. It's an important sentence. Imperative sentence begins with principal verb, late, please, etc. Solve the problem carefully. Here, as the sentence begins with a principal verb, we are sure this very sentence is an imperative sentence. Now, at first, you will have to set up late, then object to subject. Let the problem, then auxiliary verb will be, and the past participle form of verb will be solved. Let the problem be solved carefully. If the sentence begins with principal verb, to change the sentence into passive voice, at first you will have to set up let, then object to subject, then auxiliary verb will be, and the past participle form of verb. Let the problem be solved carefully. If the sentence begins with do not waste your time. If any sentence begins with do not or never, it's also an imperative sentence. Now, to change the sentence into passive voice, you will have to set up let, then not, let not, then object to subject, your time, then be, and the past participle form of verb. Let not your time be wasted. At first you will have to set let, then not, object to subject, be, and the past participle form of verb. If the sentence begins with let, let him do the work. If any sentence begins with let, then it's also an imperative sentence which expresses proposal or seeking permission. Let him do the work. To change the sentence into passive voice, let will remain unchanged. Then object to subject, the work, then auxiliary verb be, the past participle verb be done, subject to object, by him. Let the work be done by him. If we find let before the subject, to change the sentence into passive form, let will remain unchanged, then object to subject, auxiliary verb be, and the past participle verb, and by plus subject to object. Let the work be done by him. This is how we can solve imperative sentence. There are some other special rules of changing from from passive active to passive form. I will try my best to discuss the rules in the coming class. But I have already discussed the main rules of changing voice. I am sure all of you are very much well learned to this chapter, so you should practice it again and again. If you practice again and again, I am sure you will be able to solve any voice. No more today. In the coming class, I will try my best to discuss another chapter. Thank you very much. See you again.